prophet's return. Babylon will burn.
In the name of Jesus, demon, come out, demon. Come out, demon. Come out, demon. Demon, come out. Come out, demon. Come out, demon. Come out, demon.
And then laugh. The
we have to understand that lesbian, homosexuality, crooked, that's what the Bible says. I'm here to help you. I'm here to save you. Take the word of God.
The scoff is gone.
I'm not taking nothing. The Bible says drunkenness.
You need to take your
I'm not taking the word of God. The Bible says no drunkards in heaven. No drunkards in heaven. That's what the Bible says. There'll be no drunkards in heaven. I'm here to help you and to let you know the word of God.
Well, the demons have possessed them.
Will you accept Jesus? Will you accept Jesus? Why do you got a curse?
Why do you got a curse?
The Bible says no cursing. Were you drinking tonight?
You know what?
Were you drinking tonight? I'm here to help you, brother. I'm here to let you know. Time's running out.
For he says, I shall not do anything.
I'm not them. I accept the Jesus as my Messiah.
Repent, O Israel!
You gotta understand what the Bible says.
In greater days of the Greeks and the Romans, they turned to their pleasure. They turned to the things that they thought were important to them.
I don't care.
They looked at their phones and they took their selfies.
You don't love people. You don't love God. That's your problem. You love people. One, you love God. That's your problem. You need to love God. You need to love Jesus. Jesus. There's only one way. There's only one way. In the name of Yeshua, Jesus. That's the only way to be saved. That's the only way. There's only one God. Yeshua, Jesus.
Oh, my brother,
you need to put down your alcohol and pick up a Bible. You need to understand and get right with His word. You need to turn and get right with His word because time is running out. It's not an alcohol. You need to stop and worry about getting drunk, man. You need to understand it's through Jesus. That's the only way to be saved. The path is narrow. You want to be on it. The Bible says, I take no pleasure in the death of wicked people. I only want them to change from their wicked ways so they can live. So they can have life.
Come now, my brothers and sisters. Come. The word of Yahweh is now trembled across the nations. Come, for you have the judgment, for you have the word of Yahweh upon you. Deny him not, for he will not deny you. Get away from your idolatry, from your selfies, from your self-absorption in your own lives. Come. Come back to him. Worship him. He is the true great one. You have lost your ways, but you deny him not, for it is in your own heart that you know who he is. But yet you do not want to hear the truth. But there is no truth without Yahweh. Yahweh and no truth is nothing but death. Death shall appear upon you, my brothers and sisters. Come, my brother. Yes, my brother. Smile. Give it. Oh, let it scoff, for the scoffers are out. For they speak against him day and night. But remember, he is a patient God. One who has waited and waited. Give not that you let yourselves drive yourselves in your own lust. For his lust What is this lust that you shall die of? Seeking a covering. A covering, a spiritual covering. A covering that shall be upon you. That when that day of torment and tribulation comes, that you too may know that you are protected by salvation. Salvation unto you. Sure.
I love Jesus. I love Jesus.
Very good. We'll follow him.
Love him. Love him. Love him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Take of it.
He brings life.
For his day and his judgment cometh.
Hallelujah, sister.
Yes.
Very good. Don't reject our Creator.
I'm telling you there is not much time. Come now.
Here you go, sister.
Leave it alone.
Drop it. Let him go. Yeah, give the teacher. Let him read the Bible.
Teach him.
Teach
your children.
Another denying
of they shall partake in your own sins.
I'm here to
they shall deny them also.
This is a shameful
world. But he says, if you give me of your life, then I shall give you righteousness, and I shall say, your children and your children's children. Come, be not like the Greeks. Be not like the Romans. Be not like the ones against them. For I tell you as a watchman that I blow my horn now. When the day cometh, the tribulation shall come, and your blood shall not be on my hands. For your blood shall not be on my hands. For I have let you know that tribulation is coming. Come now, repent, as the time draws short. For if that time that you have to get on that ark, let not the doors be closed. But what he closed, no man can open. Lose not yourselves in your sin. We are idolaters, fornicators, homosexual drunkards. And we live in our own pleasure, the pleasure that Yahweh has given you. Go, live your lives, but say that you cannot deny him. Deny him not. Turn back, you scoffers, or you smile, you laugh, you engage yourself until tribulation comes. And when that day cometh, you will repent. And if not, you will with your gnashing of your teeth, but you shall pull away.
Yep, here you go. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise to Yah.
That's right.
But his word shall not come back void. Walk away.
Smile. God loves
deny
you.
Deny him.
Right. God bless you guys.
God bless you too.
Thank you. We need it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise to Yah.
Hallelujah.
Praise to Yah. Come, my brothers and sisters. Come. For the day of Yahweh is soon. Do not deny him. For in his day he shall not deny you to his own father. Come, seek the clothing. Seek his sacredness, his righteousness.
You know, me and my friends, we are rich. We are rich. You know, rich more than millionaires and trillionaires, because we have the great gift of Yeshua Jesus. And you all have that opportunity. How many of you want the riches that are stored up in heaven? Or how many of you want the fleshly money that's just going to waste here on earth? On immoral things and immodest things. It's never too late to change, but it will be too late on Kingdom Day. We need to read the Bible and repent and turn from our evil ways. You know, I say evil because anything that goes against our Creator is evil. You know, and we're so deceived today to think that the ways of the devil are the ways of man, and we think that's okay. That's not okay. We need to learn, and we need to teach our children the way of the Bible, so they're brought up the right way. We need to understand that the word of our Creator can heal us and help us, not hurt us. Why would anyone walk by and reject the words of our Creator? Why? Only one reason. Because they're letting their flesh, their own way, and their own desires lead their life. And they're rejecting the word of our wonderful Creator. The Bible says, if you reject me before man, I will reject you before my Creator in heaven. We need to get this right, because time is running out. Time's running out. We need to get right with it. Hallelujah means praise on Creator. It means give him the praise. Praise to wonderful Creator, Yahweh. You know, and Yeshua, the name of Yeshua, which many of you call Jesus, His name Yeshua, and that means praise Yahweh. Praise a wonderful creator. You know, we have no problem coming out here, listening to secular music, drinking, letting our kids walk around and revealing their bodies, letting our wives and our girlfriends walk around revealing their bodies, immodesty and everything. We have no issue with that.
Have you prepared yourself, O House of Israel?
What a sick time we are living in. But we have no issue with letting our girlfriends and our wives show off their body. We walk around in homosexuality. You know, we walk around drinking. We love getting drunk. But then we reject the words of our wonderful Creator who died for us. He died so we could have life, bro. Life.
See, that judgment has not caught you.
He died for our sins unconditionally. So we have an opportunity.
Make that change, my brothers and sisters.
It doesn't matter your past. What matters now is you're hearing the word, you're going to accept Yeshua and repent. Him. Repent from our evil ways. Yeshua Jesus died for us so we could have life. So we could have life. Nobody's going to walk by and say they never heard this message before. We got to teach it to our families. We got to teach it to our friends. This is the word of God, folks. The word of God says repent and change now. There's nothing in the Bible, that's negative. It's all positive. He says, I give you it all. I give it all.
Idolaters.
But he also warns you.
Drunkards.
He warns you. He says, change from your evil desires.
Fornicators.
We need to put down the alcohol and pick up the Bible. That's what we need to do. That's what we need to do.
Come back to him.
And you can hide from man, but you can't hide from our Creator, folks.
He says, turn from evil ways. For the light comes.
Accept Yeshua Jesus. Learn what the Bible says. I mean, why would you want your girlfriends and your wives and your children to walk around in modesty? Why? What thinking is there? You know, when our Creator says we should cover our bodies and open our hearts to the word of our Creator so we can have amazing blessings, why would we walk by and say we're not interested in that? Why would we do that? The reason why is because we have no fear of God.
We think
he loves the sinner just as much as he loves. No, that's not what the Bible says. He says, I hate all works of iniquity. We need to get right before it's too late. We need to change and repent.
Jesus loves you, my brothers and sisters.
You okay?
Right. Coming soon, folks. Kingdom. The kingdom is near. What are you going to choose, life or death? We need to start realizing this. We need to get right with his word. We need to understand what the Bible says about the sins of man. And we have a choice for the blessings. We need to teach it to our families, to our friends. Why would we want to associate and be around people that are sinners? Why don't we accept his word and show them and teach them the way of our Creator? There's no righteousness in getting drunk. There's no righteousness in immorality and homosexuality. We need to put down our beers and pick up the Bible. Blessings awaited you, brother. Blessings. Blessings awaited. The Holy Bible is the burnt word of our Creator, who says his Son died for us. He died for us so we could have life. You know anyone that would die for you? Yeah, I know somebody who did. Jesus Yeshua.
Well, he has paid the debt for you. I grew up a Christian. Paid that price.
It didn't work out for you, then look what you're doing now. You gotta return and repent. Read and repent. Read and repent. You know, it's not too late. It's not too late, but a kingdom day will be too late. I know exactly what the Bible says. The Bible says there's a way before each person that seems right but ends in death.
You know, this,
it says repentance brings refreshing. The Bible says repentance brings refreshing, not alcohol or getting drunk. If you think that way is better than God getting drunk, then it's life. It's life for you, baby. He died so you can have life. He died so you can have life. You can't get drunk. You can't get drunk. That's what the Bible says. It says, drunkards will not get in the kingdom. The Bible says, drunkards will not get in the kingdom. Drunkards will not get in the kingdom, it says. You know, turn from your evil desires before time runs out. We got to get right with his word. Yeshua Jesus says, accept me. If you deny me before man, I will deny you before my Father. The man walked by and says he was a Christian, but now he's not anymore. It's a joke. The only joke Satan's having with his life. We need to change and turn from our ways. We need to understand what the Bible says about sinning. We need to understand he died for us so we can have life. We need to understand it's repentance that brings refreshing. We have to start realizing that. Why would any of us want to walk around and live immodest? Why would they want us to walk around, you know, and show up for our bodies when he says, cover up, repent for our evil ways? Why does he want us to show our kids and our wives and our girlfriends their bodies? No, he says, I came to give you life so you can live. So you can live righteously, right living, living right. Nobody said it was going to be easy. You know, nobody said it was going to be easy, folks, but you know what? It's a lot harder when you don't have Yeshua Jesus.
Covering you the righteousness.
You need to accept him. Here you go, sister. You ever read the Bible? Good, good. You follow the commandments?
Bro.
You accept Yeshua as your Messiah. Very good. You follow the commandments. You know the commandments? That's good. A seeker. A seeker of our wonderful Christ. That's what he wants. That's what he wants. He says, hey, he says, all of us. He says, go. He says, go and sin no more. What about you, man? You too. You accept Jesus Yeshua as your Savior. We gotta set a word. We gotta be a light in this darkness. This darkness here today. We gotta wake them up. We gotta let them know before it gets too late. You know, if you accept Yeshua Jesus as your Messiah, you're a brother of mine. And we gotta let people know before it's too late. You know. There you go.
Yeah, well, I got one. I gave
you.
Alright. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What beat?
Right here.
We have a Bible study every Saturday at 3 o'clock in Lake Forest.
Okay.
Come on now.
Yeah, we're going to St. Louis, but we brought the touch of meat tremendously. We're going to get her baptized in the ocean.
Nice.
How you doing, brother?
Thank
Jesus
you.
Loves you.
Amen.
Amen.
Keep it up.
Thank you.
Y'all be blessed.
Hallelujah, folks. That means praise our wonderful Creator.
Come, oh my brothers and sisters. Oh, come now. Scoff not as the scoffers do. Shake not your head away and pretend you do not know him. For he will let you go in your time of need.
Okay, I'll just direct it to somebody. Okay. Hallelujah! Let people know before it's too late. Time's running out. You gotta get right with the word about Creator if you want it to be right with you.
When he came the first time, you remember that they denied him also. And at this time now of judgment, he says that the house of Israel will deny him again. But you know you are of Israel if you are saved by Jesus.
We can move closer to him.
So now, O Israel, do you not keep her laws? Do you not keep her commandments? How do you say that you abide him, but you speak not of his commandments? Keep them, my brothers and sisters. Come back to him, for you know him. For you all knew him in the old. But you have gone bitter. You walk in your own ways, in your own filth. And you say, when is he coming? When? When will he be here? But I am telling you that the day of judgment is soon. And in it, the day shall come when tribulation shall be upon you. I speak to you, all my brothers and sisters of the watchmen. In the day of Yahweh cometh, you shall not be caught like a thief in the night. Or unto the house of Yahweh.
You're good, John.
You shall come. Deny him not and come. For his ways and his commandments are upon you, all my brothers and sisters. For how can you live in his house if you don't keep the rules of his house? How can you be a rebellious bride and yet still be married upon him? For what man taketh a woman, and a woman comes to him and rebels? What type of marriage would that be? For he comes to us as a groom. How much ready are we? For the day of the wedding shall come. Will he find himself a whore? Or will he find himself a bride? A pure bride, a bride that keeps his word. The one, the word. For he is the word. For he lived a righteous life, and you shall too. For his word is great in all things. Come, for his power. righteousness shall save you. Come and deny him not with the idolaters, with the fornicators, with the liars, for the drunkards, for all those who walk away from his word. I restore you to come back. I beseech you, my brothers and sisters, do not act like this is the only time, but it is the only time for you to come. Come, receive the word. Continue on, that you may have strength in all things that you do. For his word is all. Come, you scoffers, those who smile and laugh, for the day of his tribulation shall come soon. The house of Israel, she is in judgment, and the punishment of her judgment be that you sell yourselves, that you find yourselves acquitted. Pray and find thyself to be found anointed, that you may escape these things of the tribulation, that you may not be accounted worthy, but you account yourself, for ye shall place an accountment upon you.
And you know what?
For the scoffers say, when will he come? When will he come?
When's he climax?
It is no play. I come to warn you now.
There you go.
For they scoff and they laugh and they receive him not. For they want not his word. For they want to beseech themselves of their own dirt and their own filth. For a dog returns to its vomit, and a pig returns to the mud. You have become bitter. Your churches have made you bitter unto Yahweh.
Keep rejecting God.
And I am telling you, this is not him. This is not his word. For you keep not his commandments. For it is all sin. Come, redeem yourselves.
You're not getting the kingdom.
But now you have enjoyed your evening.
Look at these
tomorrow, they think God doesn't care.
Look at this. This is how sinners act.
Look. They shall flood their sin upon the world. They shall flood to woe. The woe unto him. Woe unto them that flood their sin. For his day cometh soon. There is not much time. Turn ye back, O Israel.
Torah Life Ministries, come out of the world. Messiah people, seek the truth.